It's the story of a life lost too soon. A former Manual football player died last week.
Tonight, those who knew him are gathering to reflect and to remember. WLKY's Steve Tellier is live at the high school, where a memorial gets underway shortly. Steve?
Now, Vicki and Rick, we told everyone about the death of Daquan Drain last week. Many knew him as the running back and cornerback for the Manual football team. But tonight, they will be remembering the teen as something much more than just a football player. Daquan Drain was taken off life support last Wednesday. The coroner's office says there is still no official cause of death. They are awaiting toxicology results for that. But his friends have told WLKY that he may have died of an overdose. Those friends say the last 2 years of his life were extremely difficult. In August 2009, Daquan's mother, Toya Buckner, and his grandfather, Sherman King, were killed in a car crash on Fern Valley Road, an accident police blame on Brian Lee. Investigators say Lee was test driving a Dodge Charger at more than 100 miles an hour at the time of the crash. Friends say Drain struggled to cope with his mother's death and that he died on what would have been his mother's birthday. Now, Brian Lee's trial is scheduled to get underway next month. As for tonight's memorial service, it's scheduled to get underway at 6:30 right here in the auditorium right behind me. We'll have a complete report on tonight's memorial service tonight at 11. For now, live at Manual High School, I'm Steve Tellier, WLKY News.